Hey everybody, welcome back to Better Computer. My name is Matt, and I've shown off Claude Code before. It's a terminal-based or command-line-based interface for interacting with your code. You can write code with it, you can ask questions about your code base, but it is terminal-based. So that may not be for everybody, it may not be for every use case. And so I was really interested when Claude, or Anthropic, I should say, released Claude Code on the web, which is currently in research preview, but it's pretty cool, and I'm not going to walk through exactly how you set it up right now. The base is that you need to connect it to a GitHub account so that it can find your repositories and perform actions on them. So we're going to pull up my Quick Notes app, which I've got right here. And if I go into Xcode and build the project as it is now, you're going to see just a fresh install of the app, settings, edit, no recordings yet, and record a new thing. And there's a couple things I'd like to change about this, but primarily I'd like to actually go ahead and get rid of this edit button. When there's nothing here, don't show the edit button. We don't need that. There's nothing to edit. So let's make that not happen. I could do that through the terminal, but let's go ahead and do it through the web interface first. So when there are no recordings on the main view, we're currently showing an edit button that doesn't really do anything. Let's remove the edit button and only show it if there's at least one recording there. So I just dictated that into the text field using Aqua Voice, which is my text-to-speech app of choice. I do not want notifications, but you can. And so this is going to do something that's very similar to what you would see in the command line using Claude Code traditionally. So it's reading the project, it's looking for things, it's trying to figure out how the project works and everything, and it'll eventually make the change. Now, while this is going, let me tell you why this is cool to me. Because if I'm just working on my desktop, I probably just want to do it from the terminal. I would rather just like make the edits in real time, see them implemented in the code, make the changes, and commit them, right? But I'm not always at my computer. One really great use case I have for this right now is I can use it while I'm walking my dog. When I have an idea for like a little change I want to make, I can actually just pull this up on my phone, make the request, and it will go ahead and in the background, I can just put my phone away again. I don't have to wait for it to do anything. It will just make the change for me. And when I get back to my computer, I'll have a commit I can review and see if it works. And that is super, super cool. So this is done. You can kind of see and go back through this and see all the things that it did. Effectively, it's going to make a new branch and a new commit for each one of these chats that you have. You can create a peer review if you want, or a PR if you want, but I'm not going to do that right now. What I'm going to do is go ahead and hide Claude Code here. I'm going to go to GitHub. You can do this however you want. I'm going to fetch the origin, so I make sure I have everything. And then what I'm going to see when I go to my branches, I actually have one that I did 29 minutes ago while I was on a walk. And then this one right here, remove edit button conditions. So let's go ahead and I've switched to that branch. If I go to Xcode, I can go ahead and run it. And let's hope that it works. It does. So the build succeeds and there's no anything there. So that's great. If I go ahead and record, I actually don't know if the simulator has microphone access. So we'll see if this works. Yeah, that's a simulator issue. We can fix that. But yeah, I'm going to assume this works, but I'm not going to push this to my main branch yet. Let's go ahead and take a look at that one I did earlier. So let me switch back to just the main branch. Let's go back here and run the project again just to make sure we see that edit button is back. I'm not really demoing Claude Code now. I'm just demoing change controls, just Git things. But let's do this one we just, not the one we just did, the one we did 30 minutes ago while I was on my walk. So this was a couple changes. So before we build this one, let's go back to Claude Code and kind of see what I asked it to do. I showed it in that video, but yeah. So basically I said, there's a forever option in the delete messages after setting menu that doesn't make sense. Make it never instead. And so that's referring to in my settings, storage, delete notes after, and it's 1 day, 7 days, 30 days, and forever. Delete notes never is what it should say. This is just the name of the label used to be something else, and then I didn't change this, so just a stupid thing. So that's a like literally a one-word change that should be. And then it did that, and then I also said, also on the settings page, clean up the customization with a few subtle chips under the text area that presents stuff like extend, turn into a blog post, and other things. So I have these cleanup instructions where you can enter custom instructions, but I thought it would be nice to have some presets here you could just tap to fill in. So I have switched to that branch. Let's go ahead and run again. So there's some more changes here. This does build, so that's good. I do find Claude 4.5 to be very reliable. At least, even if it doesn't do exactly what I want, it does build buildable code. So let's go to the settings. Let's see that first option, delete notes after, never. Notes will never be deleted. That's perfect. And then I should still see these will work, and it describes when I have the setting in there what it does. So cool. And then clean up instructions, so let's see what it did. So it added some options, so an extend, blog post, sound like a pirate, professional, casual, summarize. So if we do extend, it puts that in there, and I told it to just kind of replace the text with whatever. And so these are pretty simple. I could tweak these, I could go into the code, let's see what they modified. This would be, oh, it's not going to show the diffs. So this is going to be cleanup settings view. And so, okay, cool. So I have this little array here of, or dictionary, or whatever Swift UI calls it, or Swift calls it, cleanup presets. Here are the names. Here are the instructions that it would place in the text field for me. So extend would be extend this transcription with more detail and context. Extend this transaction, or yeah, let's do provide a concise summary with key points. Yeah, so I could change these to be whatever I want and tweak from here. But it totally works. So I'm actually going to say I'm pretty happy with that. I would test more in reality, but we're just going to do it quickly. And so I could say, let's create a pull request, let's push this to main, and kind of do all those things from here. And that's just get stuff that you don't need to, we don't need to cover today. But yeah, that is, I think it's really cool. I'm going to continue doing most of my like kind of interactive, like real-time development work at my computer. I'll still do that in the command line because it's going to work faster. It's just going to directly edit the code on my machine. I'm not going to have to pull anything or change branches. Like I can just work like I would normally work. But if I am just somewhere else where I'm not able to work on it right now or whatever, having it on the web is a really cool tool that lets me just kind of get these ideas out and then have it work for like 30 seconds in the background to make the change. And when I'm ready to work on the thing again, I can just go to my computer, pull the branch and start looking at it, fixing it if it needs to be fixed, and just kind of pushing it to main if it's looking good. So yeah, that's the use case I'm using for Claude Code on the web. I think it's pretty rad. And yeah, if you want to check it out, link in the description. You can get to it from the Claude website. It's also claude.ai/code. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.